فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
The question one of the sisters asked a little bit earlier about, am I hypocritical if I just were to wear the hijab in Ramadan and then no? And you know, I told you, it's very difficult to answer that because we've got an issue. What is it? We know what is our duty, right? But we also know the reality on the ground and what it is. And we know each one has their struggles, just like I have mine. And we want to encourage you. So we will tell you, my sister, when you walked into the masjid, what did you do to yourself? You will say, well, I tried to cover myself as best as possible. Why? Because you know what? This was the house of Allah. I know I've got a duty, but when I came to the house of Allah, I felt more obliged to be more appropriately dressed in a way that perhaps I will not displease Allah in His own house. Surely that's recommended. I mean, surely it's commendable to say the least. Commendable, right? Because you walked in and you felt for a moment, hey, you know what? This is the house of Allah. When you go to Mecca, for example, you won't just walk around in your... and whatever you might have been if you weren't properly dressed. Just an example. The guys who smoke, they won't just light a cigarette and start smoking in the middle of nowhere. No, they won't. It's a sign of iman when you say, hey, hang on, this is the house of Allah, throw this thing away. Sometimes when you see a religious person, it happens that, you know, you tend to throw away the cigarette. I know of people who do that. I know of some people, they have the scarf on their shoulders, and suddenly you see a guy with a beard and you put the scarf up. I used to wonder when I was in India, and it used to happen a lot. And I used to say, am I the only man here? And I realized, yes, I am. Subhanallah. When I say, yes, I am, I mean, you know what? You got a beard. You actually, somehow, something happens to them, you know? And they just feel, no, gosh. But I want to tell you, it's from the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ regarding the angels. And the hadith says, the angels are affected by what a normal pious human being would be affected by in terms of negativity when a person does something that is not upon the level of morality or values that Islam teaches. Did you hear what I just said? So the angels, they get affected by it. Inna al-malaikata latata'adha, meaning these angels, they feel this adha, this discomfort, this pain. When I say pain, I mean it's like a grief at what is done in terms of that which would affect a normal pious human being. You know, they probably wouldn't judge, but they would feel at least to say a little prayer in their hearts if they had a golden heart. If you have a golden heart and you see something going wrong, the first thing you do is you reach out to the person with a prayer within your heart. Within your heart, say a dua to Allah. Oh Allah, help me and help them. Help me in my own mess and help them in whatever they're going through. You know, that's what it is. So for a person to practice only during Ramadan is not ideal, because what you've done, you've walked through the aisles of the same supermarket and you put all the goods into the trolley and you went to the till. The till depicts the end of Ramadan, right? And the market is the Ramadan and the goods are the good deeds, right? They're being sold. Are you following my example here? And as you're walking, you've taken so much, mashallah, and you know you've just got a bargain. You've just saved thousands of pounds in one trolley. And you've taken the trolley, you have to go to the till, right? The till is either self-help or someone cashes everything out for you. And as they're cashing it out, you need to walk out of that supermarket or store with the goods, not without them. Many of us, we've taken everything. And then we leave the whole trolley in the supermarket and we walk out. Hey, I had a bargain. There were bargains at this shop. You just lost your money. You didn't achieve anything. That's what we do with Ramadan. We do the good deeds in the month of Ramadan throughout the month. Everything was collected. We forget to cash out on the day of Eid. And we come out of Ramadan. But where's all the good deeds? We left them in the store. Allahu Akbar. Do you see the example I've given you? It is similar to what we do in Ramadan inside out. We read the Quran and outside we don't. We change a bit and outside we don't. We don't carry it through. We don't take those groceries that we bought out into the house and open them out and eat them and enjoy. We've left them in there. That's what we do in Ramadan. So we need to make sure that this time, whatever changes we've effected, we're going to try our best to maximize on the benefit outside of Ramadan.